Good morning, dear students. Today we will begin with a new concept, that is decision making and branching. Till today we have studied what is C++, how the C++ program will execute. Up to this we have studied the C++ statement will execute sequentially, that is in a program the statements are executed one by one, that is statement by statement. Sometimes situation arises such that before executing any statement, we have to check particular condition. That is, we have to make a decision. We have to test any one condition, and depending upon the result of that condition, we have to execute any one statement. That is decision making and branching. Before moving to this decision making and branching, we'll go through one simple example. That is from the standard first to tenth, you will study year by year. That is, you will study sequentially one by one. That is first standard finishing, then second standard, then third standard, then fourth standard, and so on up to 10th standard. After 10th, what you will do? After 10th, you have many options. You have many fields such as science, commerce, arts, ITI, diploma, and so on. You cannot execute or you cannot attend all these fields. Depending in such, you have to choose any one option among all these. You know that. For this purpose, what you will do? You will do a condition, you will do a test. That is, what is the test? Nowadays, the people will test that if the average of 10th is greater than 90, 80 or 90, they will go for the science. That is, if percentage is greater than 90, then they will choose science. Isn't it? If the percentage is greater than 70, they will go for commerce. If the percentage is greater than 60 and above, they will choose the arts. Isn't it? Nowadays, the people used to do the thing. But we have to choose any field, that is either science, either commerce or either arts. Any one option we have to choose. We cannot go through all these fields one by one like any first standard to 10th standard. Here we have to check the condition. The thing is, we should not go through if the percentage is greater than 90 or if the percentage is greater than 70. We have to choose any field depending on the interest and our future goal. Isn't it? We have to choose a field like commerce or science or arts, not only depending upon the percentage, but we have to choose it on our interest and goal. Isn't it? Now, leave that. The thing is, depending upon any condition, depending upon testing any condition, we have to choose any one option among many. Isn't it? But before that, first to 10th standard, we are executed statement by statement. That is, one by one execution takes place. That is, statement, one statement after another statement. Isn't it? That is, first standard to 10th standard, we will go through sequentially. The education takes place sequentially. We cannot directly go through first standard to fourth or fourth to fourth standard, I have to go to fourth. No, it is not the case. You have to execute one by one, that is statement by statement. Up to this, in C++ also we have studied that the execution of the statements takes place sequentially. Now, there are some situation arises where we have to choose any one statement for execution depending upon the condition. There are many options among which we have to choose any one option, that is depending upon the condition or testing any condition. This is called as a decision making and branching. Now, we have seen that a C++ program is a set of statements which are normally executed sequentially in the order in which they appear. Sometimes a situation arises where we have to execute a statement by checking the condition or the testing the condition. Depending upon the result, the statements get executed. The testing of the condition is known as a decision making. Whatever the condition we will test or whatever the testing we will do, that is called as a decision making. And depending upon the result, the statements which are executed are called as an branching. Depending upon the result of that condition, we will choose any one statement, that is called as an branching. The decision making and branching statement are of four types. Those are simple if statement, if else statement, nested if statement, and switch statement. These statements means control the flow of execution. They are also known as the control statement. These statements means control the flow of execution. They are also called as an control statements. These statements controls the sequential execution of the statements. That's why these are called as an control statements, isn't it? Next, simple if statement. Simple if statement, the simple if statement is a decision making statement used to control the flow of execution of a statement. It is basically one way decision making or one way decision statement. It is basically one way decision statement. The general form of this is, if a test condition, then statement block, that is true block statements will be executed, then the normal statement. Here, whatever the statements are attached to this if, these are called as an true block statements. If there is only one statement, then we should not put here the braces, curly braces, because the single statement will get automatically executed after execution of this test condition. If this test condition is true, then the true block statements will get executed. Then after encountering this curly brace, the normal statement of the program will get executed. Here statement X indicates any other normal statement of the program. If test condition is false, then it will skip its whole block. It will skip this whole true block statement and directly cursor goes to the normal statement of the program. Here we should not put here any semicolon to the if condition. Here to if condition, for this statement we should not put here any semicolon, because semicolon indicates the end of the statement, but this if condition has attached the true block statements or some statements attached to this if statement. That's why we should not put here semicolon. After encountering the curly brace, closing curly brace, the if statement will be end here itself. So we should not put here any semicolon for if statement. Is it clear? Now, the flowchart for if statement. The flowchart for if statement. Now, this is the flow chart for simple if statement. If the condition is true, then true block statement will be executed and then the normal statement of the program will be executed. Suppose if the condition is false, then it will skip this whole true block statement and cursor directly go to the normal statement of the program. Is it clear? The flow of the data comes from the upper statement. Here, the rhombus indicates the condition testing, checking the condition. If this condition is true, then it will execute the true block statement, then the normal statement of any program. If the condition is false, it will directly go to the normal statement of a program by skipping the true block statement. Is it clear? Yes. A statement block may contain one or more statement, one statement, more than one statement, group of statements. If the test condition is true, then the statement block will be, true block statement will be, block will be executed. Otherwise, the statement block will be skipped and other normal statements of the program will get executed. Now, we'll go through one program. Program to check given number is positive. Whether the given number is positive. What we need one number, we are going to store one number, that is whether the given number is positive, we have to check. So we need only one variable for that. Suppose I am taking a variable n. Next, clear the screen. Now read the value for n, that is cout, enter a positive number, enter a number. Next, scene, read the number. Now, once we got the value, go for the calculation. Now, check if n is greater than or equal to 0, then what you have to say? C out, the number is positive. Over. Then thank you is on any normal statement of a program. Now iostream.h, it is a preprocessor statement for input output statement. Conio is an input, it is a console input output for clear screen and get ch. We need a conio.h header file. Now execution begins with the main. It comes here, open curly brace. It indicates execution of, beginning of the program. Integer n is a variable created of integer type. So for n, the memory space is 2 bytes of memory space is reserved for n in the memory. CLRSCR, it will clear the screen. C out, enter a number. Enter a number will be displayed as it is on the monitor. after execution of the statement. Once the semicolon is executed, it indicates end of the cout statement. So directly cursor goes to the next line. Now cn, I will enter a value 10. I will enter a value 10. That 10 value will be stored in n after execution of the cin statement. Now once the semicolon is encountered, it goes to the next line. Now here the condition will be tested, that is, if n is greater than or equal to 0, we should not take only n is greater than 0. 0 is also a positive value. So if n is greater than or equal to 0, then the given number is positive. Otherwise, we have to discard it. So what is the n value? N value is 10. So it will substitute the value of n and it will check the condition. If 10 is greater than or equal to 0, yes, 10 is greater than 0. So this result gives true, that is, it returns a true. So the condition is true, that's why it will execute its immediate statement, that is, cout, the number is positive, will be displayed on the screen. Now once it encounters a semicolon, the cursor directly goes to the next line, that is, thank you will be displayed. Cout statement, thank you will be displayed on the screen, because whatever present in the double quotation in the cout statement, it will be displayed as it is on the screen. Now suppose if I entered a value -1, that -1 will be stored in the n, so n becomes -1. Now it will come here if -1 is greater than or equal to 0. No, it is a false, it returns false, it results in a false. So the cursor will skip its immediate part, that is, cout statement, it will skip and it will directly go to the normal statement of the program, that is, thank you. Is it clear, students? Yes. From tomorrow, in next class, we will going to study another second statement or second statement of the decision making and branching, that is, if else statement. Thank you.